Students, let us start with the balance portion of the first part of separation of substances. So let us begin. Sedimentation, decantation and filtration. Two different terms and new one, is it? We are going to study. Okay. Sometimes it may not be possible to separate components of a mixture by winnowing and hand picking. You know that what is winnowing? With the help of wind. For example, there may be lighter impurities like dust or soil particle in rice or pulses. How are such impurities separated from rice or pulses before cooking? You know the method, is it? Using hand picking, you could separate the impurities from rice and pulses. Rice or pulses are usually washed before cooking. When you add water to these, the impurities like dust particles get separated. These impurities go into water. Now, what will sink to the bottom of the vessel? Rice or dust? Why? Have you seen that the vessel is tilted to pour out the dirty water? Yes. When the heavier component in a mixture settles after water is added to it, the process is called sedimentation. When we wash rice, what will happen? Its impurities like stones will be there. When we add water into the rice, what will happen? Automatically the heavier stones like particles will deposit at the bottom of the vessel. So this process is called sedimentation. When the water along with the dust is removed, that process is called decantation. Look at the picture below. See, separating two components of a mixture by sedimentation and decantation. See, separating two components of a mixture by sedimentation and decantation. Here, in this glass, soil and water. What happened here? Due to the sedimentation process, the soil get deposited at the bottom of the glass. And here, decantation. The undissolved material, it will go along with the water. Okay? Let's find a few other mixtures that can be separated through sedimentation and decantation. The same principle is used for separating a mixture of two liquids that do not mix each other. For example, oil and water. Oil and water from the mixture can be separated by this process. For example, if we take water in a glass and adding oil or mixing oil in it, definitely what will happen? The oil will float on the surface of water. So, if a mixture of such liquid is allowed to stand for some time, they form two separate layers. In the case of water and oil, what will happen? The oil will form a separate layer on the top of the water. The components that form the top layer can be separated by decantation. When we mix water and oil, it will float on the surface of water and this oil can be separated by the process decantation. That's it. Simple. Let's again consider a mixture of solid and liquid. After preparing tea, what do you do to remove the tea leaves? Usually we use strainer to remove tea leaves. Try decantation. Is it possible? Yes, of course it is possible. Is it? Decantation means, what is decantation? Separate the water along with the dust. That is decantation. So, it helps a little. But do you still get a few leaves in your tea? Yes, you will get. Now, pour the tea through a strainer. Did all the tea leaves remain in the strainer? Yes. This process is called filtration. Which method of separating tea leaves from prepared tea is better? Decantation or filtration? Filtration is the better method. Let us now consider the example of water that we use. Do all of us at all times get safe water to drink? Sometimes water supplied through taps may be muddy, is it? The water collected from ponds or river may also be muddy, especially after rains. Let's see if we can use some methods of separation to remove insoluble impurities like soil from the water. Activity 5. You have to do this at home. I'm just reading this activity.
Collect some muddy water from a pond or a river. If it is not available, mix some soil to water in a glass. Let it stand for half an hour. Observe the water carefully and note your observation. Okay? Does some soil settle at the bottom of water? Why? What will you call this process? Sedimentation, is it? The heavier component settles, is it? So, what happens here? The sedimentation process happened. Now slightly tilt the glass without disturbing the water. Which process is working? Decantation. Let the water from the top flow into another glass. What will you call this process? Decantation. Is the water in the second glass still muddy or brown in color? Okay, you have to observe all these things, students. Now filter it. Filtration means using a sieve, filter. Did the tea strainer work? Let us try filtering the water through a piece of cloth. In a piece of cloth, small holes or pores remain in between the woven threads. These pores in a cloth can be used as a filter. If the water is still muddy, impurities can be separated by a filter that has smaller pores. A filter paper is one such filter that has very fine pores in it. Look at the picture 5.9. See, folding a filter paper to make a cone. Filtration using a filter paper. You can experiment this at home. A filter paper folded in the form of a cone is fixed onto a funnel. The mixture is then poured on the filter paper. Solid particles in the mixture do not pass through it and remain on the filter. It's an easy process. Fruits and vegetable juices are usually filtered before drinking to separate the seeds and solid particles of pulp. Of more than one method of separation. We have studied some method for separation of substances from their mixtures. Often one method is not sufficient to separate the different substances present in a mixture. In such a situation, we need to use more than one of these methods. Activity 7. Take a mixture of sand and salt. How will we separate this? We already saw that hand picking would not be a practical method for separating these. Is it? It's not, because both are very fine powder-like substances. So its hand picking is not at all possible. Keep this mixture in a beaker and add some water to it. Leave the beaker aside for some time. Leave it for some time. Do you see the sand settled down at the bottom? Yes, the sand can be separated by decantation or filtration. What does the decantated liquid contain? Do you think this water contains the salt which was there in the mixture at the beginning? Yes, of course. Is it? Our taste will be there, is it? Salty taste will be there. Now, we need to separate salt and water from the decantated liquid. We need transfer this liquid to a kettle and close its lid. Heat the kettle for some time. Do you notice tea coming out from the spout of the kettle? Take a metal plate with some ice on it. Hold the plate just above the spout of the kettle. As we see in this figure, evaporation and condensation. See, the plate is keeping here. Then the water drops that you observed falling from the plate were due to condensation of steam. This process of conversion of water vapor into its liquid form is called condensation. What is condensation? The process of conversion of water vapor into its liquid form is called condensation. Did you ever see water drops condensed under a plate that has been used to cover a vessel containing milk? It has just been boiled. Yeah, so many times, is it? So many times you may have noticed. After all, the water has evaporated. What is left behind in the kettle? We have the separated salt and sand and water using the process of decantation, filtration and evaporation and condensation. We have used the four methods to separate sand and salt. Paheli faced a problem while recovering salt mixture with sand. She has mixed a packet of salt in a small amount of sand. She then tried the method suggested in activity 7. Look at that. Okay, you refer activity 7. To recover the salt, she found, however, that she could recover only a small part of salt that she had taken. What could have gone wrong? Can water dissolve any amount of a substance? In chapter 4, we found that many substances dissolve in water and form a solution. We say that these substances are soluble in water. When a substance dissolves in water, we will say that it is soluble in water. What will happen if we go on adding more and more of these substances to a fixed quantity of water? You can experience all these things. Okay, at home itself, you can experience all these things. Activity 8. You will need a beaker or a small pan, a spoon, salt and water. Pour half a cup of water in the beaker. Add 1 teaspoon of salt and stir it well, stirring until the salt dissolves completely. Where it has seen in the figure 5.14, see the figure 1.554, it has shown. Then again, add a teaspoon full of salt and stir well. Go on adding salt, 1 teaspoon full at a time, and stir continuously, stirring. After adding a spoonful of salt, do you find that some salt remains undissolved and settles at the bottom of the beaker? Yes. If yes, this means that no more salt can be dissolved in the amount of water we have taken. The solution is now said to be saturated because that much of salt we have added and dissolved in that amount of water. So, here is a hint asked what might have gone wrong when Paheli tried to recover large quantity of salt mixed with sand. Perhaps the quantity of salt was much more than that required to form a saturated solution. Is it? The quantity of salt was much more than that required to form a saturated solution. The undissolved salt would have remained mixed with the sand and could not be recovered. She could solve her problem by using a larger quantity of water. Okay. She used more salt and less water. That was the mistake she made. Suppose she did not have sufficient quantity of water to dissolve all the salt in the mixture. Is there some way that water could be made to dissolve more salt before the solution gets saturated? Activity 9. Take some water in a beaker and mix salt in it until it cannot dissolve any more salt. That means more salt. When compared to water, you have to mix more salt. This will give you a saturated solution of salt in water. Now add a small quantity of salt to this saturated solution and heat it. What do you find? What happens to the undissolved salt in the bottom of the beak? Does it dissolve now? Yes. If yes, can some more salt be dissolved in this solution by heating it? Experiment this one also. Let this hot solution cool. Does the salt appear to settle at the bottom of the beak again? Okay, the activity suggests that larger quantity of salt can be dissolved in water on heating. Does water dissolve equal amounts of different soluble substances? Let's find out. Activity 10. Take 2 glasses and pour half a cup of water in each one of them. Add a teaspoon of salt to 1 glass and stir till the salt dissolves. Go on adding salt, 1 teaspoon at a time, till the solution saturates. Saturate means until no more salt get dissolved in the water. Okay, record the number of spoons of salt that dissolved in the water. See, in table 5.2, now repeat the same activity with sugar. Repeat this with some other substances that are soluble in water. Okay. What do you notice from table 5.2? These all are experiments for the students. You have to do at home itself. And you can write the experimental result here. We have discussed a few methods of separating substances. Some of the methods of separation presented in this chapter are also used in a science laboratory. We also learned that a solution is prepared by dissolving a substance in a liquid. How we prepare a solution? A solution is prepared by dissolving a substance in a liquid. A solution is said to be saturated if it cannot dissolve more of the substance in it. Okay, students, that's all for today's session. Keep watching my channel, subscribe the channel and support me. Thank you.